It's your boy Constavist 34, and the Dave Matthews Band has been nominated for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I'm happy for the band. I'm excited to see them get some exposure here in this way. And this has been heavily anticipated by fans that, you know, there's been a lot of votes. You look at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, at the end of the Hall of Fame, there's been a voting count, and DMB has been in the top five from pictures I've seen online all summer, including one of my buddies who went there. Now, I also think about past members of the band, Leroy. Rest in peace to Leroy Moore. I know he's smiling from heaven. He's probably jamming right now with Jimi Hendrix and Dwayne and Greg Allman. And Chris Cornell is probably singing some vocals as well along with them. They're having an awesome jam session up in heaven. And I'm sure he's happy to see this as well. And I think of Butch Taylor and what he's meant for the band, his key playing, and many other people. Steve Lillywhite, another key component of how this band was recorded, and just many other tons of musicians that have been part of former lineups or played in for parts of the time. But I'm excited for this. Now, we want to get into how I personally feel, and we'll get back into some other stuff. Now, am I happy for this nomination? Yes. But does this nomination actually, if they don't get the selected, am I going to be upset? Absolutely not. To me, the impact is more important than the award. The impact got them nominated, and the impact, even if they weren't nominated, means so much more. You think of the Grateful Dead. The Grateful Dead only had a couple top 10 hits, and their first top 10 Billboard hit was in the 80s, you know, one of the last albums. So the Grateful Dead don't have awards, and they don't have certain stuff that other mainstream acts in rock and alternative rock have gotten. But the Grateful Dead's impact is larger than the majority of acts outside of like the Rolling Stones, the Beatles, and a couple others. They sold out stadiums. Same thing with Dave Matthews Band. Okay, they don't have all of the top 10 hits. Come Tomorrow didn't chart as far as like the best album of the year. They weren't up there with Taylor Swift and Ed Sheeran and those other people. But the music, how it impacts you, is what matters. And that's why I don't care if they do not win. I don't care if they never win, to me. Because again, to me, the impact is more important. How they've impacted my guitar playing, how they've impacted my personal life. Listening to Drunken Soldier during my first marathon on the last mile, just very emotional and hurt and broken down, and almost felt like quitting until I heard the chorus of Drunken Soldier. That's what resonates with me. Not if they get a medal, piece of metal, a golden star, or they get on some sort of like chart. I don't care. So that's how I feel. And you can feel hurt if they don't win. You know, that's your, you know, you can feel however you feel, but that's just how I feel. That the validation via Grammys or via some TV late night show, I don't care. I don't care about that. I like to see them get the shine, but if they don't win, it doesn't matter to me. And, you know, shout out to some of their peers that have been nominated. My boy Biggie Smalls, baby. Soundgarden, RIP to Chris Cornell. Oh, my favorite grunge band is Soundgarden. I know people like Pearl Jam and, you know, and Nirvana. Soundgarden is the one that, to me, just impacts me the most. We have Nine Inch Nails and a couple other, you know, Depeche Mode. So it's great to see the peers with them. But again, it's not going to impact me if they win or not. Another question everyone has, is Boyd going to be asked to come on stage if they win and get nominated? I don't know, to be honest, but Boyd, I mean, he doesn't look like he's in a good spot right now. That's not, I don't know for sure, but just the way I've seen some live streams of his shows, he just doesn't look good. He looks like he's moving in slow motion. I don't know what's going on, but maybe if on stage, I don't really see them bringing Boyd up. They may acknowledge him, but I don't see them inviting him. And it may be for his good. Just he does not look good. Respectfully, does not look good right now. Seeing some live streams from a couple different stops on tour, seeing how he plays right now, he definitely cannot perform with the band. Just respectfully, he can't perform with the band. If he was even invited, he's got to be in the crowd or just up on stage. I don't think he could play with this band right now or next year. The other thing about this is I talked about SiriusXM. This was something where the petitions, that's not going to work. Guess what? They didn't work. There's no more DMB radio. It is what it is. But here is something where the power of the fan base, the excitement of the fan base will work in the band's favor. People will vote for them nonstop. I mean, the reason that they're in the top five of the, like, when you go to the Hall of Fame and you see how many votes they've gotten this year, the reason they're there is because of how excited their fans are. They can't sell out a stadium like Ed Sheeran or Beyonce or Taylor Swift, but the concentrated amount of fans go to so many shows. They're so energetic online. Nearly 30 years after this band kind of really started to get a gathering as they came up on their come up. So that'll work in their favor that they are going to have an energetic fan base that will vote, that will engage. I mean, the DMB fans, as much as they don't sell albums that much well anymore, like Come Tomorrow wasn't a top five selling album of last year. The amount of support that people have for the band, the amount of shows people go to still, in this era of the band, it will reflect on the fan voting, which is a component of this. So let me know what you guys think. Definitely like, comment, subscribe. It's your boy ConcertViz34. That's all I got for right now. Congratulations to the band. Peace.